Today is Easter Sunday 2022, and today I'm going to look at some of my whirligigs which have been damaged by the high winds which we have had recently. And as a matter of fact, the winds this year have been stronger than ever, more frequent than ever. They lasted longer than ever since I moved to Denver, and that was in 1980.
Red flag warning and high wind warning again today. So for me, one of the answers was what this friend of the earth sends to us every day for free. So let's go back to the strong winds and the damage they have produced with my whirligigs, and I will then show how I will repair some of these Whirligigs. He lost his hammer. He also lost part of his hammer. He lost part of the axe also, very minor.
So let's look at some of the damages. First of all, the Easter Whirligig has lost its propeller. The propeller just broke off, and I have to replace the drive shaft. So that is one of the minor damages to repair. It just broke off. Another damaged Whirligig is the seesaw Whirligig. The drive shaft came off the Whirligig and the propeller lost part of one of the panels, and that will be fairly easy to repair because I do not have to replace the whole drive shaft. The barrel organ Whirligig also was damaged. This time the propeller just broke off. And for this particular one, I also need to replace the drive shaft because there's nothing else I can do. Another one which was almost totally destroyed was the carousel. There it, first of all, some of the propeller blades were broken off, and then the whole thing here, the whole carousel was pretty damaged. I may be able to fix that. Not too difficult. The most severe damage was done to the Ferris wheel Whirligig. That one was more or less destroyed. The Ferris wheel is probably beyond repair and has to be rebuilt. It happened when the whole Whirligig blew off its base and fell to the ground. And unfortunately, it fell in a way that the Ferris wheel was severely damaged. Since these strong winds are probably here to stay, I'm trying to find a solution, especially for these two cases where the propeller just broke off, and they have in common that the drive shaft has been threaded so that a nut can be put on the propeller. It could be that when the winds are so strong that they dislocate part of the Whirligig and it gets stuck, and then the propeller is trying to move and trying very hard, the wind's very hard, so that this strain on this thread is so high that it just breaks the rod with the thread. So the wind being very strong and some of this gets stuck, then the propeller tries like crazy to turn, and it's such a strain on this threaded rod that eventually it'll give. So to avoid this problem, I'm going to try this other design which I used recently, which is instead of threading this rod and putting a nut on it and tightening the nut, I will just bend the rod around here so that it catches the propeller, or the propeller catches the rod, and then carries the drive shaft with its movement. And since there is no thread, then I hope that the rod will be stronger and not break under such stress. I have to remove the drive shaft first. So I said, have to take it apart. I have to take this off first. Meaning I have to unscrew the whole barrel organ so that I can move this out. There's a reason that I am not gluing if I don't have to, and I'm using screws so that I can remove parts if necessary. Here's the drive shaft, which I have to rebuild to remove these nuts from the propeller. So I have to make sure I remember how it was before I disassemble it. Here's the arm. This part comes off. Now I have to duplicate this bend. Which is not so easy, because it has to fit exactly. Thank you.